Here's Tony, the Conway Salvage Art. He specializes in the salvage of unwanted materials, barns, old junk, and he also makes art. 3 years ago, I did a story on him. I had never met him, and I walked around his place after driving by numerous times. He's lived there about 10 years, and this display has been added to constantly. He's always on the lookout for salvaged materials, not only wood, but nails, screws, anything you can see. He uses corks and bottle caps and all, and just about anything under the sun. 3 years ago, when I looked at this, I began to wonder just what was inside his house. I could see a little bit of it, and at the time, I didn't know him, and he has a little gate up that says, do not enter, so I assume that no one's supposed to go in there. Anyway, in the corresponding time, though, we've talked, and we arranged to get together. I was able to, this was about 2 weeks ago, meet him. I had met him a few times before, but not anything but a few minutes, and this was more of a meeting. This is a stairway up to his house, and he's relaxing a little bit. He sat and talked. Every piece of art he has, inside and out, there's a story behind. Now, he performs an important function by taking the salvaged materials and reusing it. What a better thing for the environment can you do? If, in fact, you need some unique material for, say, a accent wall or a fence, this would be the place to do it. Here is a good example of a reuse of a material which was to be thrown away. He took a bunch of old horse tack and made this horse out of it, and it's on display in his front yard. I really like it. Okay, back inside. Now you'll see that he pretty much covers everything he has in artwork. Some of it's repurposed art, some of it's just from scratch, depending on what he was doing. For example, he made this banjo out of salvaged materials, which I thought was pretty handy. Being able to play it was even nicer. Like I told you before, he wants collectibles, things hoarders might have collected over a period of time the family gets rid of when they pass away or something. And one of those things he acquired was pencils. Lots of pencils bundled up from somewhere down around Arizona, I think. And you can see, you might wonder, what do you do with it? Well, one simple thing was to make one giant pencil out of several, which I thought was kind of unique. This is really cool. This is it's about just under 3 feet. It's his interpretation of the Tower of Babel is completely made out of pencils, which I think is kind of appropriate. Also, the piece that goes with it, as you can see, has its own energy. I was amazed. It was really hard to photograph. I tried flash and every other thing. The depth of field still made it look like it was in motion. Yeah, Tony, he did it. I'm going to leave his number and his email for you if you need to get a hold of him. Drop off unwanted materials. Call him first, of course. He always accepts wood, nails, anything like that. This is one way you can support him. If you do have the time, stop and drive around his house. Handy if you're elderly or it's raining. If you do have more time, they'll walk around. That's a real treat. Call him up. Here's his number. Get a hold of him and maybe check out some of his art. I know you'll enjoy it. Hope you have a good one. And hats off to Tony. He's a real hero up there in Skagit Valley. Take care. Good night.